Nadolol is a non-selective beta-adrenergic antagonist used for the management of arrhythmias, angina pectoris, and hypertension. In this video, let's find found. What is Nadolol? What is Nadolol used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking Nadolol? How does Nadolol work? How to use Nadolol? What is Nadolol? Nadolol, sold under the brand name Corgard among others, is a medication used to treat high blood pressure, heart pain, atrial fibrillation, and some inherited arrhythmia syndromes. It has also been used to prevent migraine headaches and complications of cirrhosis. It is taken orally. Nadolol was patented in 1970 and came into medical use in 1978. It is available as a generic medication. In 2020, it was the 340th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 700,000 prescriptions. What is Nadolol used for? Nadolol is indicated to treat angina pectoris and hypertension. Another product formulated with benzoylflumethiazide is indicated to treat hypertension. Contraindication. Nadolol and other beta blockers should be used with caution in people with heart failure, and its use should not be abruptly stopped. It is contraindicated for people with asthma, a slow heart rate, and certain severe heart problems. Side effects. The most common side effects include dizziness and fatigue. Pharmacodynamic. Nadolol is a non-selective beta adrenal receptor blocker that is used to lower blood pressure. It has a long duration of action as it is usually taken once daily and a wide therapeutic index as patients start at doses of 40 mg daily but may be increased to doses as high as 240 mg daily. Patients taking Nadolol should not abruptly stop taking it as this may lead to exacerbation of ischemic heart disease. Mechanism of action. Although Nadolol is described as a non-selective beta blocker, it does not interact with beta-3 adrenal receptors. Antagonism of beta-1 and beta-2 adrenoceptors in the heart inhibits cyclic AMP and its signaling pathway, decreasing the strength and speed of contractions as well as the speed of relaxation and conduction. Antagonism of beta-2 adrenoceptors in the smooth muscle cells of the vasculature inhibits their relaxation, leading to an increase in peripheral vascular resistance and reducing the risk of severe hypotension. The increase in peripheral vascular resistance may contribute to the decrease in insulin sensitivity associated with Nadolol use. Antagonism of beta-1 adrenoceptors in the juxtaglomerular apparatus of the kidney inhibits the release of renin, and therefore angiotensin II-mediated vasoconstriction, aldosterone-mediated water retention, and the release of epinephrine. Antagonism of beta-2 adrenoceptor liver and skeletal muscle inhibits glycogenolysis, in the lungs prevents bronchodilation, and in the pancreas inhibits insulin release. Half-life. The half-life of Nadolol is 20 to 24 hours. Dose. Hypertension. 40 to 320 mg POQ day. Angina pectoris. Initial 40 mg per day PO, increase gradually Q3 to 7 days. Doses up to 160 to 240 mg q-day may be needed. SVT, maintenance, off-label. 60 to 160 mg/day PO. Aggressive behavior, upper GI re-bleed, off-label. 40 to 160 mg/day PO. Migraine, prophylaxis, off-label. 40 to 80 mg PO q-day, up to 240 mg per day. Other indications and uses. Off-label, arrhythmias, GI bleed, hyperthyroidism, reduce IOP, SVT. Safety advice. Nadolol is considered a pregnancy category C drug. Research has shown it to reduce birth weight in infants. Breastfeeding women, it is also contraindicated postpartum as it is expressed in breast milk. It may induce hypotension and hypoglycemia in neonates and infants. That's all the information about Nadolol we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video, to update more health information.